you, you are there, you have the ability, but they render you useless. As though you are incapable to do it. Any spirit that brings another person in replacement of yourself, just bear and distinguish you from the power.
Yes, sir.
Another will not do your place.
Amen.
If your enemy comes up better, you are the one I'm talking to.
Amen.
If your enemy comes up better, you are the one I'm talking to.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Carry your Bible, Mark chapter 2.
Hallelujah.
Mark chapter 2. From verse 1.
You are the Lord in three persons.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Are you Mark chapter 2? From verse 1. Everybody look at your Bible. Let's read together like a choir. One, two, go.
And again he entered Capernaum after some days. And it was heard that he was in the house. Immediately many gathered together, so that there was no longer room to receive them, not even near the door. And he preached the word to them. And when they came to him, bringing a paralytic man who was carried by four men, and when they could not come near him because of the crowd, they uncovered the roof where he was. So when they had brought him through, they let down the bed on which the paralytic man was lying. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." And some of the scribes were sitting there and reasoning in their heart, "Why does this man speak blasphemy like this? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" But immediately when Jesus perceived in his spirit that they reasoned thus with themselves, he said unto them, "Why do you reason about these things in your heart? Which is easier, to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Arise, take your bed and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive." He said to the paralytic, "I say to you, arise, take up your bed and go to your house." And immediately he arose and took his bed and did what? And took his bed and did what? And go to your house. And immediately he took up his bed and went out of the presence of them all, so that all were amazed and glorified God, saying, "We have never seen it like this before." Watch, walk to seven people, tell them, raise your life, raise your belief, also raise your faith. Say, raise your life, raise your belief, and raise your faith. I'm preaching on radical faith.
Look at somebody, say, faith that is radical.
I didn't hear you say faith that is radical. Say better, say radical faith. Stretch up your two hands towards the altar, everybody. I decree upon your lives from the altar of grace. I prophesy.
I receive.
Any matter that is killing your faith in your life, any matter you are passing through that is making you lose faith in God, any matter you are passing through that is making you think, "Where is my God?" Any matter you are passing through matter does it affect your name, it makes you stop at a place. There are some of you under the sound of my voice. That is the place where you have been for the last 5 years, for the last 7 years, for the last 10 years. You have done all you can to live from that place. And yet you have refused to move. There is something in the realm of the spirit that has paralyzed your leg. It has kept you at a place. I prophesy to you, when my eyes were opened, any one of you who undergoing spiritual paralysis, any one of you who marriage is undergoing paralysis, any one of you who destiny is undergoing paralysis, today I command the strength that you have lost over the years. Let the strength return back to you. I say, let the strength return back to you. Let the strength return back to you. Let the strength return back to you.
Walk. You have leg, but you can't walk. Your leg can be good. I've seen people who are paralyzed, their leg is full, it's not thin, yet they can't walk. What happens when the devil wants to paralyze a man? Your leg will be there, but the strength in your leg will be taken away. Am I preaching to somebody here? In no shalata kukaraga baba ninta. I read in my Bible, in Isaiah chapter 37 verse 3, the Bible said, this says Hezekiah, today is a day of trouble, a day of rebuke, a day of blasphemy, for the children have come to the point of death, and there is no strength to deliver. So, when the devil wants to paralyze you, your leg may not cut off, but the strength in your life will be taken. This woman in the scripture, she had the ability to carry a child for 9 months. On the day of delivery, her strength vanished. That is paralysis. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? Stretch out your hands, everybody. I don't know where they took away your strength. I don't know where they took your strength from. I don't know how they collected your strength. But I have good news for you. Isaiah 30:31. The Bible said, God has been wrapped up in the world. Shall renew their strength. They shall mount up their wings like eagle. They shall renew their strength. He said to Ezekiel, prophesy to the dry bones, so shall live again. And Ezekiel says, can you hear you alone now as well? And he said to him, prophesy, son of man. And Ezekiel looked at the dry bones. He said, you dry bone, I command you, come back to life. The Bible showed there was a great noise in the valley. Bone was meeting with bone, flesh was meeting with flesh. Strength came from on high. I prophesy to you, anyone that took your strength from, release your strength from above. 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 What you committed to last year, you shall do this month. What you committed to last 3 months, you shall do this month. What you committed to 7 years ago, you shall do this month. What you committed to last 3 years, baby, put it in your hand in 3 days. You will shine like a cloud. You shall be great again. It is the sun yesterday. It is the sun today. It is the sun forever. When God says yes, your mind can say no. When God opens a door, your mind can close it. Anytime God lifts you up, your mind can bring you down. God is on your side. 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 Lift your hands up for you. Lift your hands up for you. Lift your hands up for you. Take your seat. Take your seat. Watch this. Look at me. The Bible said the guy was crippled. And one day, Jesus came. Jesus was preaching in the temple.
his friends saw and heard about the coming of Jesus. Now look at this. The young man could not carry himself. Am I talking to somebody here? But the Bible said he had four friends who carried him. In this season, Lita Kakamanga, Shatatanuka, we have four corners of the earth, North, West, East, and South. I declare in your life, you will never be stranded in life. I say you will never be stranded in life. You will never be stranded in life. You will never be stranded in life. In the presence of the right people, things are easy. He will walk, they won't carry him. Any day God wants to change your life, God will start bringing to you friends who can believe that your condition is not permanent. You know they hear me. There is no condition that is permanent in life. The problem some people have is that they have people around them who make them believe that their condition is permanent. The day God will favor you is the day God will begin to bring people that will give you reason to live again. No, Shanada Bahata. Kaluta Kosha. The Bible said when they came to the place, the crowd was too much that they could not enter through the door. You know what they did? Can I shock you? They went on top of the roof, opened the roof, and brought the guy in from the roof. Can I tell you something? It means that those four guys were wealthy. Because a poor man cannot remove the roof of another man's house. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? I declare upon your life. Are not the same. If KK jam you and the trailer jam you, the impact are not the same. There are people that will enter your life. If you have a problem of 5 million, you don't make call twice. Am I talking here? That is why you need to pray a prayer. Oh Lord, change my company. Your company, listen to me. Who is around you determines who you become. Show me your friend. I will show you who you are. That's a pathetic image. A perambulator rigmarole in a similar conjunction. Anybody you follow is who you become. If you have nice people around you, your life will become better. But when you have nice people around you, life goes down and gets worse. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I preaching here? Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, the right people are locating me. Hey, there goes a mananana mashanta. Elagabarondo sabrata. The guys were bad enough. They didn't care to know how much the roof was. They said, no matter what it will take, this guy must not remain here. I bring to you good news. Everybody who has made you settle in your level, I decree today, God God will change your compare for you.
Look at neighbor, say neighbor. I need correct people for a better life.
Say, I need correct people for a better life. Say, I need correct people for a better life.
When the right people are around you, they will help you. And they help you out of shame. You know, there are two kinds of help. There are people that help you and help you into sorrow. There are others that help you and help you out of sorrow. I will explain. Anabadakushata. I read about a man in the Bible. His name was Mephibosheth. A grandson of Saul. A son of Jonathan. When they came back to Mephibosheth, he was not crippled. His legs were good. But the Bible said, when he was, how many days? 5 days old. 5 days old. There was battle in the house. The Bible said a nurse carried him and was running. Something took her leg. She fell, and the leg of that boy, that was how he became lame. He was not lame from birth. Somebody was helping him to save his life. And helped him into being crippled.
I have seen people, their business to be going well, and probably they need a little money to boost it the more.
Once you collect money from that man and enter the business, the money will dry all the one you have.
It was a help,
but that help helped you into sorrow.
There are things you will take from people,
it will choke you here.
I've seen women who come crying to me. They say, man of God, if I knew,
I wouldn't have taken that money from him. He's looking for me everywhere, anyhow. He said, if he doesn't sleep with me, he's not going to do it. And he has given me a deadline to pay that money.
It was a help,
but the help entered sorrow.
There are others that help you
and help you out of sorrow. Stretch your two hands.
Neighbor.
Correct people. Now watch this. How come those guys had that kind of faith that if this guy sees Jesus, you know what that faith is? It's too radical.
No space. Go.
They say no. We must.
Sir, there is no room.
He said, we must.
Few years back,
I went to preach in a church in Lagos, an Anglican church. After preaching, the lady that was cooking for me, she the first day she cooked, and I ate. After eating, I preached. And when she came the next day to bring food with the people, she said, man of God, I've been looking for a child for 12 years. Can you pray for me? I said, okay, I'll pray for you at the last day of the program. It was a 5-day meeting. I preached the third day, fourth day. And after the fifth day, I was supposed to pray for her. I forgot because of the crowd everywhere. They were rushing. Everybody wanted to touch me. So the protocol were guiding me out of the reach of people so I won't be devoured. And because of that blockage, the woman could not even reach me. So she was standing there crying. I was discussing with the priest
by the car. He's the man of God. You can go. So we're talking. She was crying, stretching her hands. I couldn't pray for her because of the car. If you tell her to come, others will rush. I entered the car and they drove me out. I didn't know that as soon as I left, she went straight to where I was standing, discussing with the vicar. She carried the sand where I marched. She lifted her clothes and she rubbed on her stomach. She said, if there is a God that he serves, let me set. Bring his anointing upon me. Listen, when a man is anointed, you wear clothes, your clothes is anointed. You match a place, is anointed. You touch a hand. I'm not talking to somebody here. I'm not communicating here. I never knew what happened. The next year, I came back for same convention. When I came, after preaching, the first day, they brought food. It was not tasting like the one I ate last year. And then I now asked them, I said, what of that woman that cooked for me last year? Why is she? They said, ah, you'll see her in church today, sir. I didn't know what happened. Something else covered the story. The second night, I was preaching. A woman was sitting down in front carrying twins. I couldn't recognize her because she had delivered and she has increased in her stature. And after the meeting, she came to me. She said, I am the woman. You refused to pray for last year after cooking for you. I said, I didn't refuse. What happened? He said, you refused to pray for me, but I had to take it myself. Radical faith. Radical faith. What did you do? She said, I took sand from where you marched and I rub on my tummy. And your God answered me. He said, today this is my evidence. The woman of the issue of blood, Jesus did not give her the healing. She collected it herself. Jesus no give her. She took it. He said, you no one give me, I go take her. People were touching Jesus without ambition. She touched Jesus with ambition. And as soon as she touched Jesus, bah, something left Jesus that he didn't give. You can take it even if he doesn't want to give you. Somebody say radical faith. The Bible says, calling those things that were not as though they be, as though they were. You know they, but you they call them like say they. When I never had a car, when I was very young, I was still in secondary school. I was a preacher then. And one day I came out and I was talking to the people I was living in the boarding school with, in my SS2. I told them, I said, I have a car. I have what? They were looking at me. Said, this guy is going crazy. This is pastor thing, is entering his head. SS2. If we come out from boarding school to go to school, I will, after bathing, I will dress, I will carry, even if there is scarcity of water in the hostel, I will carry 1 gallon of water. I will come outside, I'll be pouring it. What are you doing? I'm washing my car, invisible car. SS2. My first car came in SS3. As soon as I wrote WAEC, it came. You're not understanding me. When you get to a realm where you begin to see yourself in a place where it doesn't look like you can enter. Yes, sir. That is faith. Yes, it doesn't look like you can. It's just like you don't have anything you are doing. Your capital is nothing. Your salary is 14,000 and you are going to price a land of 10 million. Am I talking to somebody here? Look at the neighbor's in neighbor. Jesus did not look at the guy who was crippled. Jesus did not look at the roof they removed. What did he look at? The faith. He said to them, as the doctor told you, you will die. Tell Jesus, see my faith.
faith. For if your faith can come like that of a mustard seed, you shall say to this mountain, be thou removed from here and become a plain, and it shall be moved. Faith! Faith! A small boy in the Sunday school was always hearing the pastor. Every day he would say, if you can say to this mountain, be removed. A child in Sunday school. One day they were coming back. There's this big mountain on the road to their house. He stopped in front of the mountain and he said, by what I was taught, I said to you, mountain, be thou moved. His brothers and sisters were laughing at him. The next Sunday, they passed. They still saw the mountain. He said, the mountain not there here. He kept on saying it. Bro, don't close your mouth. Keep saying it. Don't stop saying it. Keep talking it. It doesn't look like it will happen. But one day, monkey go go market, people go come back. That thing you have been saying, I release it in your life. That thing you have been saying, I release it in your destiny. That thing you have been saying, I release it in your career. I release it in your destiny. I release it in your future. You have been meant to be conquered. You have been meant to be conquered. The matter is, he that is in you, and he that is in the realm, you don't serve a dead God, you serve a mighty God. He is my son yesterday, he is my son today, he is my son forever. When God says yes, no man can say no. Shut your lips and shut fire.
Am I preaching here? Am I preaching here? Look at the Bible, say it is possible.
For with God, all things are possible.
With who? With who?
Minus your uncle. Plus God, minus your father's connections. Some people stay inside water, soap enter their eye. God know they there. You don't need them. You need God. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of faith. Am I preaching to somebody here? He said, I will look unto the hills and upon the mountains. From where cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, the maker of the heavens. Hey, Adabashata. Somebody say faith. Jesus was talking one day. He said to them, he said, take no thought. Take what? Somebody said, take no thought. Take no thought. Do you know what it means? It means no thinker. No do it. Say no thinker. Say take no thought.
Take no thought.
Say it again. Say take no thoughts. What you will eat, what you will wear, what you will eat, where you will live, what you will do. Am I talking to somebody here? It doesn't mean you should not think it. Listen, listen. You know, God is a grammarian. He's a grammarian. Eh? Eh? He's the creator of English. He said what? Take no thought. It doesn't mean you won't think about it. You can lie down and say, my heart strength has expired. What will I do? I'm facing embarrassment. Hey, I don't have money for school fees. My business is going down. What will I do? I need money. You are thinking. But any time you begin to live in fear, you have taken the thought. So he said, think, but don't take the thought. So take no thought. What you will eat, what you will wear. Take it. It looks like it can happen. Don't take it.
Thank you, sir.
No money in your account. Don't take it. Refuse to be a poor man. I am a billionaire.
I carry generational mandate.
as a neighbor. Take no thought.
Am I communicating here? He said, if your heavenly father knows how to, he said, if you who are evil know how to give gift to your sons, to your daughters, to your children, how much more your heavenly father? How much more your heavenly father? Stretch your two hands. 72 of you under the sound of my voice. Anything people have said, you cannot produce. In the next 1 month, you shall distribute it to people. I said, in the next 1 month, you shall distribute it to people. I said, you shall distribute. A radical faith. Number one, run away from faith distractors. If you must possess radical faith, run away from faith distractors. Those four guys, the both of them had unity. If one of them said, why are we bothering? If the other one said, I'm not going to leave this guy, you will see that they won't be able to do that. But they did it because four of them had focus. They were not distracted. The day somebody will start distracting you from church, that day you are losing your faith. I know you've been coming. There are some people that will say, I brought my friend, he has got a miracle, I brought this one. They give you reasons and reasons. They say your destiny is not there, it is others that are there. If you go to your house and stay, it is not even better. So you better keep going until God remembers you. Every day is for the thief, one day is for the owner. Life is done by turn. Shine, I shine. When your chapter comes, no man can stop you. I was preaching somewhere and I said to them, the most dangerous man on earth is not a man carrying a bomb. The most dangerous man on earth is a man, his time has come. Because if your time comes, nobody can stop you. That's the most dangerous man on earth. Not a man carrying a teledo. He's a man whose time has come. There are people, when you tell them you want to give this to God, because of what you're looking for, they discourage you. They make you not to do. Anytime somebody around you begins to discourage you for what you want to do for God, run away from that person. They are faith destructors. Distractors. Pharaoh said to Moses, he said, Moses, he said, sir, he said, you can go with your wife and children, but don't go with your animal. Why? In the lineage of Pharaoh, he knows that when Moses go with their animal, they sacrifice in the wilderness, the presence of God will come and give them direction. So for them not to bring down the presence of God, don't go with your animal, so they can go there and get confused. He doesn't like sacrifice. Any spirit that when you want to sacrifice and he says don't do this, that see of that spirit is eating the object of your sacrifice. Never you get to a point when you want to do something for God and a voice comes to distract you. If you listen, they have won your faith. That is why sometimes scripture said, when your right hand is doing something, hide it from your left.
there are personal sacrifices that can be done. Life is a race. Every race is on your head. You don't run race like couple. Jesus doesn't come to carry couples, he comes to carry people one by one. When couple want to do family sacrifice, they do. If God lays in your heart, do what God said you should do. Am I preaching here? Run away from faith distractors. Anybody that gives you a reason not to go to church, run away from him. Anybody that gives you a reason not to believe God the more, run away from him. Slap your neighbor, say, I hear. Say, I hear. Say it again, say, I hear, I hear. Number two, if you must express radical faith, you must maintain your focus. Maintain your focus. Maintain your focus, irrespective of the delay. Maintain your focus. Everybody's miracle will not come at the same time. There are people, their own will come before others. So if somebody's own comes before your own, don't be distracted. Don't look down on yourself. Maintain your focus. Have your belief, irrespective of the delay, because everybody's destiny is not the same. Jesus carried the scripture and he read in Isaiah. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor, to set the captives free, to heal the sick, and this blah 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 blah. He said, today this scripture has been fulfilled. Where? In your eyes. In your eyes. In your eyes. After preaching, after reading it, the next verse said, and he closed the book and gave it to the preacher man. What does it mean? Preacher man, I have read my own. Look for your own and read your own. Everybody has what is written concerning them. When your own happens, it flows. When another man happens, it flows. Don't you ever compare yourself with somebody else. Because when God visits your neighbor, it means that God is in your neighborhood. So the next door can be your door. So never you pray for your neighbor when God visits your neighbor. Because when God visits your neighbor, God just entered your neighborhood. Your door may be the next door. Slap your neighbor, so I'm here. Maintain focus, irrespective of delay. Joseph had a dream, and a man called Shalata. His dream was almost becoming a nightmare. Now let me shock you. How many of you know that God never told Joseph he'll be a prime minister?
whatever you get from a shortcut, write this down. Anything you get from a shortcut will cut short your life. Anything you get from a shortcut will cut short your life. Life is a process. Destiny is a journey. Don't jump from 1 to 7. Pass through the process and become who God wants you to be. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, say, I hear. Say it again, say, I hear. Say it again, say, I hear. Say, I hear. For you to flow in the realm of radical faith, number 3. So, what is number 1? Run from faith distractors. Number 2, maintain your focus. Number 3, have I said it? Okay, I should say it. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor. Never confess negatively. That's number 3. No matter how bad the situation is, don't allow negative confession to come out of your mouth. The Bible said, as you speak into my ears, so shall I do for you. The day your mouth starts talking right, that day right things begins to happen. Wrong things are product of wrong sayings. For whatever that comes out of your mouth is what you shall see. Genesis chapter 1. And God said, 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 and God said. In verse 30, he said, and God saw that all he has said and created were good. So when you keep saying, you start seeing. Don't say wrong things. Never you look at headache and say, that's my headache. Has come back. Any day you say that my headache, it becomes a headache permanently. There are some careless words you use that are wrong. Daddy, imakwa anyama hebidolo ozo oga wanyagi. It is not your own. Every sickness is a visitor that expires one day. So if you understand, you will stop claiming them to be your own. Am I preaching here? Say, it's not my own. Some people will do one business, do two business, do three businesses. They will all fail. You want to do the fourth one? You say, ah, with this one work. As you said, with this one work, you have killed that business. It will never work. You are the best prophet to yourself. What you speak over your life determines what happens to you. Be positive in all you say. Never you look at your children and you call them blockhead. When you call them blockhead, their head becomes block. When I was small, listen to this. This is true. I used to tell my father every day, even my wife would be laughing. I said, when I was small, if my father buys me a new sandal for school, he say, nah, this is your new sandal. So thank you, daddy. He say, tomorrow, got it here. Tomorrow, got it here. Now, he's thinking, he is warning me not to cut it, but he's prophesying that the thing will cut. Tomorrow, got it here. I say, daddy, I will not cut it. I'll wear it, small ball. Others will wear the one and be playing big ball. It will not cut. When I do small ball, that prophecy will come and cut it. And if I come back, they'll say, and tomorrow, cut it to you. I'll say, yes, sir. And it must cut. Because what you call your dog is what your dog will answer.
Yes, sir.
Am I preaching here?
Yes, sir.
If your children go to school and they don't do well, don't tell them next year, carry class in your head again. No! When they come, No. Hey, you get 23 out of 25. Kneel down, mashata kota baria linata. Esefelenete kuragada. Next year you do well. Next session you do better. Next session you do. As you prophesy, they get better. If you have been blocked, next year they'll become 25 out of 25. Negative confession. It has scattered a lot of things. Amen. Most of the outreaches we do in rainy season. Am I right? And when we do outreaches, some pastors will call me. They say, "Ah, how you go manage rain?" I say, "Don't talk about it. It's not a consideration because rain can't fall. As you speak it, so shall it be. Rain has never failed." Look at your neighbor. Say, "Neighbor, mind what you say." Say, "Mind what you say." Say, "Neighbor, don't kill your miracle with your mouth." In the name of Jesus. Finally, let me close. The final number what? Somebody say number what? Number four. Number what? Number four? Number four. For you to express radical faith, you must learn to celebrate and thank God in advance. Touch your neighbor, say celebrate. Thank God in advance. You never do more, but you thank him. Isaiah 54 verse 1. Sing, O barren, you who have no child. He didn't say you who have a child. You know they hear me so. Isaiah 54 1. Sing, O barren, thou that does not bear, break forth into singing, cry aloud, thou that has not traveled with a child. For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married woman, saith the Lord. Sing, O barren. You are barren. You don't have a child, but sing. Satan wants you to be crying, but come on, open your mouth and burst into singing. When the devil sees you shouting, when you should be crying, he gets confused and leave you alone. Am I preaching here, Becky? Look at your neighbor, say, "Neighbor, thank God in advance. Thank him in advance. Don't wait for it to happen. Say, it is done. I am married. I walk in my marriage." Am I communicating here? See it walk and give him praise. Am I communicating here? Now, when you see it walk, when you see it happen, you give him praise about it. And when you give him praise, you begin to act like it has happened. Change your clothes. Remove these clothes. There are some ladies that are sitting down. You have been praying prayers, fasting, going from one church to another. You fasted every kind of fasting, afternoon fasting, fruit fasting, red oil fasting, palm oil fasting. You've done all the kind of fasting in this whole world, and yet it didn't work for you. And right now, you are so depressed in your spirit. You go to church just for going sick. When you go, you are not in any department. You are not in any. When the pastor preaches and says, "Receive favor for marriage," you say, "Amen." You are sitting down like Sikiluku. You are there. Nothing is exciting you. You are not. When you are down, too down, you don't go out. You don't mix with people. How can the marriage come? You have to showcase what you have. Enter ushery department. Walk around in the service. Let people see what you are made of. Am I talking to somebody here? People that get married in this church are ushers and protocol. Have you asked yourself why? As I am preaching, they are giving seats. Sometimes they are in the brother, they are shopping it very well. And before you know it, after service, they are here meeting behind somewhere. They are not depressed. They see themselves working in what they believe. Give a neighbor high five. Say, "Jesus." Take it down. Hear me. Hear me. I like this one. Give the offering well. Let us see you. God punish Satan. God punish Satan. Keep giving the offering. Let's see you.
That devil is a liar. I'm going to get your somebody here. Look at your neighbor. Say, "Neighbor. Loneliness. Shine.
Show yourself. Take it down. Show yourself. Am I talking to somebody here? You are not Elizabeth. You are not Elizabeth that was pregnant and God said, go and hide yourself for 5 months. You are not Elizabeth. Don't hide yourself. Show yourself. Am I talking to somebody here? When a man keeps seeing, one day he will say it. Prophecy swallows leprosy. Am I preaching here? Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor! Follow your faith. Live in your faith. Believe in your faith. Possess your faith. That's the truth. That's the truth. The day I met my wife, I came to preach in their church in Lagos, Anglican Church. Amen. Make her talk. I came to preach. She no come church. First day she no come. Second day she no come. Third day after preaching, I called for some fund support because they were building. The mother came out to sow a seed. The next day, the mother no come. The mother carried the money, give her. May she go drop for offering bus. At the preach, 9% enter church. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I communicating here? I was saying something serious because she didn't come to stay. She came to drop the offering and went back. She was actually cooking. They live close to the church. So she walked straight to the offering box and dropped the offering. Bah! As she dropped it, I wanted to. I said, come here. When she came, I said, stand. She stood. She thought I wanted to give prophecy. There was no prophecy. I was assessing God's creation. God punished the devil. And that meeting, we are married for 5 years. Stay counting. If she was in the kitchen, I won't see her. Say, I hear her. Can I close now? Madam, stand up. Can I talk to you? Lida Gada Mozatakushia. Stretch your hands, everybody. The Lord opened my eyes, and as I was just passing, I saw in your house, I saw another woman. Your husband, two wives.
You're right.
Your husband married you after 10 years. He married another woman.
Yes, sir.
Now, in that 10 years, you had 3 children. All girls.
You are right.
He married another woman because of a male child. And when that one entered, that one had only girls too.
You are right.
You later got pregnant for a son. Delivered that boy. You people slept in the night. has made sure that they pushed you out of the house because they feel that you are a witch. And she wants to kill your husband and take everything he has. Your husband is a wealthy man. Very wealthy.
Yes,
I see filling stations everywhere. He's into oil and gas.
Yes.
His name is Godfrey. Just because she wants to take everything. But the Lord says, I should tell you. He said, you left the house last month. They pushed you out.
Yes.
Eh? And by your age, you are not supposed, you are supposed to have entered your menopause. Or menopause is not menostop.
I hear.
God said to me. God said to me, sir. He said, you left the house. You are not one. He said, you are two. Can I say it again? You are not one. You're two.
You are two.
There's a baby in your womb.
And that baby, the baby child, tell your husband tomorrow, tell him you're pregnant. I'm not saying you should go for test first.
Faith, collect those things that were not as though they were.
Listen, tell him tomorrow, tell him I'm pregnant.
He will run to you. He will carry you to test and confirm it. And when they ask how long, he will know he's the one, not another person. And as I speak to you, when the news of that pregnancy comes out, the charm of that woman will scatter in his eyes.
And everything she has done to destroy your marriage, it shall be destroyed by fire. If your enemy comes out better, God will release it upon you.
Obonye kahana chuku ha.
Obonye.
Obonye kahana Jesus Papa. Chuku ha. Isi ne poti kahu papa yana la hai la rodi.
Oga ne kole bobe.
Eh. Ole dash. Manga dash.
Hmm.
You were going to drop offering. God said I should talk to you. Come. We are taking away from your sight for 21 days. Every day one. Every day one. Every day one. You have a house?
Yeah.
You're building?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
In the village?
Yeah.
21 blocks. 21. Motaha. Lebadashka. Let me talk to you. Let me talk to you. Yes. Let me talk to you. Come this way. Are you married?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Are you married?
Yes.
Come. I speak life. You're gonna live, oh my brother. My sister, I speak life. You are the head and not the tail. Monika tolide kakuku borone denga. Eshkiza sa nunini angandi rando shi branda hasa. Mama yandash.
Logos. Permanent.
God said, don't cry. He won't die.
I hear you, sir.
He won't die.
I hear you, sir.
He won't die.
I hear you, sir.
You are remaining only two in your family.
Yes.
Only two.
Yes.
You, we are six.
Yes.
They killed four.
Yes.
Remaining you and your brother.
Yes.
And that your brother is in coma as I speak to you.
Yes.
You gathered money because of him. So you can. The doctor said bring money.
Yes, they asked me to bring
250,000. Yes. You don't have it.
No.
But you went and borrowed money, gathered money from people.
Yes.
You were going to the hospital. You entered keke.
Hey.
Yesterday.
Yes, so
the people in the keke, we are dupers.
Yes.
They charmed you. And they collected the only thing that can save the life of your brother. And they told you after what they did with you, that did you tell anybody you will die? Stop crying.
Oh, how
you lift me. Come.
From grass,
yes,
to the grave. Jesus lift me from the grass to the grave.
Shake me three times. Shake. Hit my hand three times. One, two, three. Look at my face. Let me shock you. The money they stole from you today, they didn't plan it today. They have followed you two times. They missed you. And today, as soon as you left the bank, there was a keke that was following you from the back. The keke is yellow in color.
Yes.
As soon as you left the bank, you took half a million.
Yes.
As you parked, you came down, entered, came out, opened your car to take the money. You didn't see the money again.
Exactly. That was what happened.
This today, this afternoon.
3 o'clock.
3 o'clock today. Now hear me. The people that took it followed you twice. Now they are going to follow you again tomorrow. Because what you need the money for, you still want to do it. So you go back to the bank tomorrow.
Exactly.
Now, when you go back to bank by 11. Where's the woman I was praying for now? Where is she? Stop crying. The Lord said to me, no more money. It's as if there is no hope for your brother.
Oh,
you are crying. Because if he dies, it will remain only you.
Yes.
God said to me, from this church, go straight from here,
yes,
to FMC.
Yes. I hear you, sir.
Take.
Yes, sir.
My handkerchief. No money in your hands.
No.
Place the handkerchief on his head.
Yes.
He has not opened his eyes for 2 weeks.
It's true, man of God.
Place the handkerchief on his head. The altar where they have placed his name. And remove his name from the altar.
Amen.
Remove his name from the altar.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Place it and leave it there. In the night, as you are sleeping, he'll be the one to wake you up. Congratulations.
Power!
He won't die.
Amen.
And look at what God will do. Between now and Wednesday, the person that wants to keep and wipe away your family, God will make him mad.
Anybody that wants to finish your life, wants to finish your family, I command you to confess and die.
Shake me two times. One, two. No more loss in your life.
Amen.
Tomorrow, God will expose them. Because by 11, when you go back to the bank, they will be following some other people. They will be taught, and you will hear it along that same road where they took your own. That's where it will happen. And they will be caught. And they will confess that they're the ones that took your own yesterday. I decree today, let the wall of fire be built around your life.
Amen.
You will never lose nothing again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Grace is upon your life.
Amen.
Shake my hands. Go outside and bring. Alright, let me pray for you. The Lord says, I should decree upon everybody here. Any project you started, you will finish it by grace.
Amen.
Lift your hands. Wherever they've taken those blocks to, and they've frustrated your life, frustrated your efforts, your business, and they say things cannot work. Today I release you.
Amen.
And I decree a release upon
Amen.
You.
Amen.
I command those things that they have done against you to destroy.
Amen.
You will finish that house in 2 months.
Amen.
Your visa has been held. For how long?
Up to 7 months.
7 months. Yeah. I release it before September 15th.
Amen.
Congratulations.
Amen.
Lift your two hands and let me close.
Oh, yes. It's true.
You had it cash in your account.
It's true.
You bought three lands.
It's true.
You started the house. But within 1 year, everything you have gotten, you sold it.
It's true.
As I speak to you now, to eat is a problem.
Yes, sir.
It started with your house burning.
It's true.
Your international passport burnt.
It's true.
Everything about your life burnt.
It's true.
Everything you have achieved has gone.
Yes,
you became sick and you treated yourself with every money in your account. And right now as I speak, everything has been scattered. God said to me, your problem is not from the village. There's a girl you disappointed. Am I talking to you?
Yes, sir.
Now let me warn you, young men. There are some people, sir, that they get into anything they want. They do anything they like to anybody they see. Everybody is not the same. There are people that are more than you. You don't treat them like trash and go free. Because when you treat them, they treat you back. And when there is no prophet over your head, when they treat you, your life is in danger. If you see where men, where men are breaking the hearts of little girls that did nothing to them, you wonder whether they are beasts. That they don't have conscience. You got her pregnant.
Yes, I don't know.
Six times.
It's true.
Am I saying the truth?
Yes.
You were not ready for marriage.
It's true.
After the first one, you say remove. Second one, remove.
It's true.
Third one, remove.
It's true.
Fourth one, remove.
It's true.
Fifth one, remove.
It's true.
Sixth one, when they were removing, the doctor said that the womb is destroyed.
Yes, sir.
That they should remove the womb. So she asked you, if I remove my womb, will you still marry me?
I said yes.
You said yes. But from the day they removed the womb, you never saw her again.
It's true.
You changed your line because of her.
It's true.
You don't pick her calls. You rejected her. You destroyed her. And you forsook her. And she went to meet her grandfather, who is a native doctor. She's from Ibuzo in Delta State.
It's true. It's a Delta woman.
What your neighbor say, professor?
Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments and my thoughts. Let them rise, ceaseless praise.
Can I close? Can we help him?
Oh yes.
Can we help him?
Oh yes.
Go and look for Ijeoma. What's her name?
Ijeoma.
Go and look for her. Go and look for her. Ogula. When you beg her, apologize.
Yes, sir.
You bring her.
Yes, sir.
She will tell you all she did.
Yes, sir.
You don't need to go to native doctor to scatter it. Bring her to me.
Yes, sir.
Let's pray prayers. And restore your destiny. If not, you will die like this.
Thank you, sir. I will do that.
So bring her. Look for her. Look for her.
Yes,
you don't have her number. Go to where they were living before. You were staying in Lagos.
Yes, sir.
They lived in Surulere.
Yes, sir.
Yes, go to Surulere and look for her. That place they were living. Go and bring her. Get her. Pray for her.
Yes, sir.
Beg her. Bring her. I'll pray for her. Am I communicating? I decree, as you shall do this, your destiny will come back alive. In the name of the Father.
Amen.
Son, your destiny is bright. This guy is destined to build 5 churches for God before he dies. But because of his misconduct, he has been tied and finished. Everything is gone. Your life is better.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Do what I said. God will restore you. Congratulations. Let me pray for you, young man. Are you a pastor? Eh? Are you a pastor? You need grace. Lift your 2 hands. At the count of 2, what I have comes upon you. Now, it is too much. Hold it. I speak grace into your hands. 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 wherever you touch from now becomes a success.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everybody lift up your phone. Everybody lift up your phone. Lift up your phone. Lift up your phone. Mazata. Lodash. Mekuta. Mashata. Ledaga shilaba radadaba. Ragada shidahata. Lebrodosa. Bring out your phone. Lift it up. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
It is done.
Amen.
It is done.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
By next week, I'll hear testimonies.
Oh, yes.
That person you've been calling that refused to pick your call. When your call will come, you will run and pick your call. Hey, hey, hey. They shall be the one that will call you and fall. Hey, hey, hey. Shall you hear? I receive. Congratulations.
Thank you, Father.
Be blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Satata libaranadabasha. Metakusha. Take up